KPY SNSX was supposed to be held on 9th January, but it has now been delayed. So before it comes up, we should be doing, hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel, Prosun Panda, and this is Eban Mitro, KPY SX AIR 374, NEET AIR 165, JEE Main AIR 2993, and JEE Advanced AIR 9739. I've also qualified for the aperture test of KPY SA, and today we are going to talk about that due to the delay in the KPY SA and SX examinations, what should students further do during the journey of 11 and 12 so that neither the time is wasted nor are they set off course on the target for KPY. So without wasting much time, let's get started with this video. The KPY and SA and SX examination was supposed to be held on 9th of January 2022, but 1 or 2 days earlier, due to a large number of requests pouring in from students of class 11 and 12 on various social media platforms, it was delayed. Let's hope that this delay is not more than a month or two. So there are 2 types of students right now. Some students who have not exactly utilized the time till now, especially if they're in 11, and they're thinking that since it has been delayed, I've now got a fresh lease of life and I will use this time in developing my skill set, in reading up on some physics, chemistry, biology, and improving on some maths concepts. But if you wasted the time, that's the main problem of 11 and 12. You do not have time to press the rewind button and start from over again. Life is a challenge. Face it or go. But those who have studied seriously till now, or those who have studied seriously but still are finding some concepts weak, for the latter especially, it's a golden time, because you have got some amount of time, even if it's 1 or 2 weeks, to improve on that concept. Or if you have already found that concept appearing in the previous examinations, which I believe are very important for you right now, in the context that the examination will be delayed by, let's hope, not more than a month or so, it's like a God-given gift, because now you know exactly what type of strengths you have and you do not need to work further on those, and what type of weaknesses you have, and you have a clear idea of moving ahead, that in this 1 or 2 weeks, or say at the most 1 or 2 months, I have to focus on these weaknesses, and if there are some parts which I do not know but are very important, then I will try to know at least some part of them. Now there are 2 types of KPY, as you know, KPY SX and SA. So KPY SX is given by class 12 students and KPY SA is given by 11 students. So for 12 and 11 students, it's completely a different ballgame. If you are in 12, then due to your upcoming JEE and NEET entrance examinations, you will anyway be studying, I suppose, quite hard, and no point in elaborating it more, because in the course of the study, while you're preparing for them, you will also be preparing for KPY. And for those who are absolutely focused on KPY and are absolutely interested in ISC or one of the premier ISIS, you should be focusing like that only. If you anyway want a good timetable to proceed on your journey and to help you study effectively, then I've already made a video on that, and feel free to check out that video, and I've linked it up somewhere here or here, so make sure you do that. If you're an 11, then there are mainly 2 parts that we have to discuss upon. First is an academic part. If you feel your 11 prep is not that good, then focus on strengthening your core concepts. KBPY and easy questions, only core concept questions, and not on very, very difficult problems, because KPY tests you more on core concepts than problems which are complicated and you will need 1 or 2 rough pages to completely get to the bottom of the problem. If you feel your 11 prep is quite satisfactory, then try to get some concepts like a bit of organic chemistry, a bit of free optics, and some amount of genetics in biology. I know this might sound a bit difficult for people who are preparing for JEE, but it will be better if you can do some genetics, because if you can master some amount of genetics, then you're sure to get at least that 4 or 5 questions right in that biology section, and some concepts of probability and a bit of 2D and 3D geometry under your grasp. Really? Do you think that you could do this right now? Now, the second point is the non-academic part. This non-academic part is only for those who have a firm grasp on the 11 and a little bit of the important parts from 12, which come in the entrance examinations and not just the entire 12 syllabus, or people who have decisively completed the 11 and now have a very clear understanding of where they will score that requisite amount of marks, say that 50 marks, and which part they will leave absolutely and they are sure that they absolutely cannot attend.
There are very few people in this world. Less than 1%, I think.
But these types of people are very rare. These type of people should ideally try to improve on communication skills for the interview and prepare a topic for the interview, especially if they have set their eyes on IISc Bangalore or one of the premium ISs in a country. IISc or nothing. Oh, sorry. Ideally, this step which I'm talking about should be preserved after getting an aptitude test results. But if somebody is very excited about getting into IISc, then I believe that you should work on this step from right now only.
You fool! You should be studying right now, not doing all this and that and that and this.
If you like this type of content, consider subscribing, hit the like button, and share with as many people as you can. If you want some tips on productivity and by which you can study better and live a more productive life, you can click on this link which I've given up here or here. Or if you want to bust some myths related to common Indian UG entrance examinations like NEET UG, KPY or JEE, then I've also linked this up somewhere here or here on the screen. Make sure to check those videos out, and we will be soon coming up this week to discuss about how to read something properly. You'll have to check that video out when it comes on this channel. And till then, adios amigo and peace out. And also be putting up some behind the scenes role at the end of the video, so make sure to check it out. Really, there should be two sections, one non-academic and another non. Then will they always play or? Okay. Really?